topic 5.6, part 2, chromosomal inheritance, nondisjunction, and chromosomal variation. Some of the questions we'll be addressing include, what is nondisjunction? What are the consequences of nondisjunction? What causes Down syndrome and Turner syndrome? I'm Mr. W from learn-biology.com, where we believe that interaction and feedback is what leads to deep, substantial learning. We're so sure of that, that we provide a money-back guarantee that comes with your subscription. What is nondisjunction? What are its consequences? Nondisjunction is kind of a cool word. So a junction is where things come together. A disjunction would be things coming apart, and nondisjunction means things failing to separate. It's when the homologous pairs or the sister chromatids don't separate during meiosis. There's a couple of variations. In meiosis one, the homologs don't separate, and as a result, so you see that over here, this blue chromosome over here, these homologs didn't separate, they stayed together. So the result is that in meiosis two, we're gonna have three chromatids on this side, three over here, one over here, one over here. So 50% of the gametes are N haploid plus one extra, and 50% are N minus one. So N, the haploid number, missing a chromosome. If nondisjunction occurs during meiosis two, it involves the sister chromatids not separating. In meiosis two, the sister chromatids don't pull apart. So the result is that 25% of the gametes are N plus one, 25% are N minus one, in other words, the haploid number but missing one, and then 50% of the gametes will be normal. So that's what nondisjunction is and how it can happen in meiosis one or meiosis two. Are you looking for a better way to study for the AP Bio exam and to get an A in your AP Bio course? At learn-biology.com, we've got exactly that. We've got quizzes, we've got flashcards, we've got interactive tutorials that'll help you master the material that you're studying. We have comprehensive reviews for the AP Bio exam. We'll help you switch from overwhelmed to outstanding student. See you on learn-biology.com. We saw in the last slide how nondisjunction during meiosis one or meiosis two can result in gametes that have an abnormal number of chromosomes. If the eggs are N plus one, they have the haploid number plus one more, then the zygote will have an extra chromosome. Then what we have is a trisomy. And what that means, tri is three. Instead of a homologous pair with two, we have three. The most famous example of that is Down syndrome, which is a trisomy of the 21st chromosome, which has various developmental consequences and developmental delays. If the eggs are N minus one, like over here or over here, and the sperm again are carrying a normal number of chromosomes, so that's not necessarily the case. You can have nondisjunction that occurs during the formation of sperm as well, but then the zygotes will have a missing chromosome. So they'll have all of the homologous pairs, but one will be short. And the result of that is a monosomy, and most of those aren't really survivable except in the case of the sex chromosomes. So one to know is called Turner syndrome, where instead of females having two X chromosomes, they have one. And there's a significant amount of variation that could happen in the sex chromosomes. There can be men who are born with an extra X chromosome. There can be men who are born with an X and two Y chromosomes. So those are all chromosomal variations that come about through nondisjunction followed by fertilization. Want to learn more? Sign up for a free trial of the website that guarantees your AP Biology success, learn-biology.com, and watch this next video.